Hi everyone, I'm Harshvardhan, an artificial intelligence engineer, and you're watching another WebGuy YouTube channel. And today we are going to build a very interesting project of face mask detection using computer vision. So for this project, we are going to use TensorFlow 2.x and computer vision module for Python, that is OpenCV. And if we talk about our project, we will divide our project in three different parts. First one is pre-processing, where we will pre-process our images, then we will train the model, a TensorFlow model, and then we will classify using the trained model. So we will talk about it later on in much more detail, but let me show you a demo of what you will be building. So here's the demo. So let me run the cell. So now you can see that here at the top it says mask no, because I'm not wearing my mask. Now let me wear it. So here you can see that we got mask yes, because we have that. And if I remove it, you can see that again we have mask no. So let's get started. And if you have not yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. So let's start working on our project and learn how we are going to achieve our aim. At first, the question is, what is our aim? So we have to build a recognition model that can check whether a person is wearing mask or not. So here we have three different stages. So at first we have pre-processing stage, then we will train our model, and then classification. So here in the pre-processing, I have already written a helper script for you that will make this task easy. By the way, our aim is to walk into the folder, that means the data set, and check all the images or grab all the images, read that image, convert that into a 50 by 50 pixel of gray images or a grayscale image, then save that image into a data array and the target into a target array. That means whether the person is wearing mask or not. And then save that array to a data.npy file and target.npy file respectively. Then we will have to train our model. So for this, we will use TensorFlow. And here we will load the data, reshape that data into a required form. Then we will split the data for training and testing. We will create our TensorFlow model and then train and save the model. And the saved model will be used for the classification whether the person is wearing mask or not. So here we will take two different approaches. At first, we will learn how to classify a static image. That means we just have an image and we will try to classify that image and we will check whether our model is performing or not. And then we will use live classification. That means you will grab the live feed from your camera and will check whether the person is wearing mask or not. So let's start with the pre-processing file. So at first we will take a look on the architecture of the folder, or you can say how the folder are distributed in your source code. So this is a workflow IPython notebook file where you will find the workflow. That means how you are going to achieve your aim. And then this is your data generator.py. This is a helper script that I have written for you so that you can get clean data from the raw data set. And this raw data set have three different folder. One is test folder, train folder, and validation folder. This dataset was created by Prajna. You can check that Prajna ASP GitHub for the complete dataset, but I have cleaned all the data for you. So in this test data, you have with mask and without mask, and in that folder, you have images. Similarly, it is for the train and also for the validation. To make this project simple, I have just summed all the images present in that folder into a data file and a target file. That means we are not using test separately, train separately, and the validation separately for the simplicity of the project. If you want, you can obviously do that. And now let's have a look on data generator.py. That is the helper script. I recommend you, if you don't understand this code, no problem. You just have to run this file and it will just go through all these file present in this folder and create a file that is a npy file which will be saved in training folder. This data.npy file and the target.npy file that will be used to train your model. And this IPython Odoo file is your file for training the model. And here you have classification file that we will use cnn.hy, which is our trained model, and two different IPython Odoo file, which are the live face mask detection and the static face mask detection. That means we will check whether the person having a mask or not using an image. So let's have a look on datagenerator.py. So let's have a look on all the modules that are required for this pre-processing. We have three important modules. One is OS, then CV2 and the NumPy. And this time is just for your simplicity so that you can see the log at the end of this the file completion. That means even after the file is completed or execution is completed, you can see all the logs. And now this total file function will just count the number of images present in the folder. That means it will crawl or it will walk through all the files present in that folder. That means the dataset folder, and it will count total number of images present in the dataset and it will show to you. Then we have some variables here. So here we have two array. One is target and another is data. They are actually a list in Python. And then we have a dictionary with mask represents by 1 and without mask is represented by 0. Then we have a skipped 0. It is just for checking whether any image is skipped or not, that you will get as a log when you are running the file. And then here we have a base empty string. Then you have dataset folder name, ignore files and image save. So this base is the base location. That means this particular location, base is empty. That means this raw data set is present where this data generator is located. And data set folder name is the name of the folder where your images are present. And ignore files are the files that to be ignored. Like here we have readme.md. And that file is to be ignored when crawling or walking through your folder. And from here to here, we are just going through each and every folder. And we are reading the image, converting them to the grayscale image and resizing the image into 50 by 50 form. So here you can see that we have image shape, and this image shape is defined here, which is of shape 50. So the image will be reshaped into the size of 50 by 50. And if there is an error due to which the image is skipped, then we are incrementing skip by 1. And at the end, we are saving the file or the array we have created here, data array and the target array, to a file which is the data.npy and target.npy, and these two files are saved in the training folder. So now let's train our model. So here in the training, I will just go to this face mask detection model training. So at first you need to import some modules that are NumPy, Matplotlib for showing the images, then TensorFlow, and from TensorFlow.keras you will import sequential and layers, because we are going to build a sequential model. So you will import all these modules. Then you have to load your data. And remember that you will load the clean data. That means that data.npy and the target.npy. Now, here you can see that I have a statement or a syntax that says tf.keras util.toCategorical. Now, in this statement, we are just converting our target to categorical value. That means at first you have 10110, that will be converted to 0110, then it will again convert it to 01, it will convert it to 01 and it will be converted to 10. So here you can see that how the data is converted into categorical. So it will be 01 and it will be 10. It will be 01. Then we will just take a look on our images. So we will just say data and a random number, that is 890 I took, and checking whether the person have a mask or not. And then you are checking the target and it says 01. That means yes, it have the mask. So now we are pre-processing our image that is required for TensorFlow to train the model. So at first, we have to create our image into a three-dimensional image. Why? Because TensorFlow want a three-dimensional image. So I have given some links here. You can go through these. So at first, we are just copying our data to a O data variable. And then we have an N data, new data array or a list. And then we are reshaping our image into a three-dimensional image and normalizing it between 0 to 1 so that it will be easy to train it, right? And then we have copied that N data to the data. So here's some important thing you need to understand that. So here you will ask why this 1 is written here, and I should recommend you to go to this link, and they have given you the explanation why you have to use this 1. So it says as tf.image grayscale to RGB requires the last dimension to be 1, and this convert to tensor so that this tf.image.grayscale to RGB can use that image to convert your one dimensional or two dimensional image, that means one single channel image, to a three dimensional image that is in RGB. And the process to convert a grayscale image to a three-dimensional image or a RGB image is just to copy that single image in three different layers. So it will become a three-dimensional image. You're not going to give a color to your image. You will just take the image and you will stack three times to create a three-dimensional image. That is done by grayscale to RGB method from TensorFlow. Then we need a train test split so that we can split our data into train x, test x, train y and test y. And then we will just cast that into a array and save that back to train x. And also I want to show you the shape. So here we have the shape of our image that was 50 by 50. And then the channel is 3 and the number of images is 1651. And now if we talk about the train y, it's of 1403 and the dimension is 2. That means you have two elements and the total number of rows is 1403. And remember that we are using the test size of 15%. That means of total images, we are going to take 15% of image for test. Now we have just shown the images, that means just for visualizing that what all images we are going to work with. And now let's have a look on image shape. Why image shape? Because we are going to tell that to our model that what image shape is going to be passed through the model. So our image shape is 50 by 50 and the channel is 3. And now this is our sequential model where we will use 4 convolutional neural network, and then we will connect them to a dense layer with 64 neurons, and then at the end we have 2 neurons. We'll check whether the mask is yes or no. Then we are using Adam optimizer with the learning rate of 0.001 and the loss is categorical cross entropy. And the metric we will use is accuracy. Now if we take a look on our model summary, we will find that we have more than 400,000 parameters to train. Now let's train our model for 50 epoch with a validation split of 0.2 and the batch size of 100. So here you can see that at the end, we got the validation accuracy of 97% and the accuracy of 99.82%. And you're always free to hyper-tune the model. And please let me know the better model in the comment section. And we have just plotted the accuracy and the validation accuracy using matplotlib. And you know that if you save that model.fit into a history, then you can get history.history as a dictionary. And from the dictionary, you will grab the accuracy to plot that. And then we are evaluating our model and checking its accuracy. It's 95.56%. And then saving our model in cnn.h5. Now let's have a look on classification. So we will begin with static face mask detection. That means at first we will detect using an image. So again, you have to import some modules that are TensorFlow, and from TensorFlow you are going to import Keras, then CV2 module and the matplotlib. Then you have to load the model. So for loading your model, you will use cross.models.loadModel and the model name. So your cnn.h5 model will be loaded in the model variable, and you will check the model variable. You will find that it is a sequential model that we have built. Now we have our image in masked person.jpg, and we will read that image using cv2.imread that will be saved to master I, that means master image. Then we are converting that image to grayscale image, and we are reshaping or resizing our image to a dimension of 50 by 50. So remember that we are doing the same thing that we have did in our pre-processing file. Because if you give a 100 by 100 image or any other dimension instead of 50 by 50, the model will say, "Hey man, what are you doing? You have trained me using the image with a dimension of 50 by 50. So you have to provide me an image with say the same dimension. So you have to do that." So we will reshape our image or resize our image into the dimension of 50 by 50. And then we will convert our image to grayscale using grayscale to RGB method of TensorFlow. Till here, you have reshaped your image into row, column and channel. But to predict, your image should be in 4 dimension as you have trained with batch size, row, column and channel. So to convert your image in this shape, you have to use image.shape 1 and then asterisk and image.resave. So I have provided a Stack Overflow link here. You can check out this link for more detail. By the way, this one is the batch size and this asterisk.image.save is the REST operator in Python. If you have work with JavaScript, you will know that what is a REST operator. By the way, I will show you how this REST operator works. So let's create a tuple. I will say A is 1, 2, 3, and now I will say B is equals to in the list of A. Now let's check B. You will find that there is a tuple present inside that list. So if you want to expand that 1, 2, 3 as a list, what you will do? Either you will cast that into a list, or you can use this operator, that is a REST operator. So I will just say asterisk. Now here you can see that our tuple is expanded in the form of list. That means here we have given the list. So this is the aim of this syntax or statement. So let's say we have a tuple of 50, 50, 3, and we are reshaping it in 1, asterisk of A. So at the end we will get such kind of dimension 1, then 50, comma 50 comma 3, where 50 comma 50 is the row and column, and this 3 is the channel, and 1 is the batch size. And then we are just showing the image. So after the conversion of your image in the dimension of 50 by 50, it will be like this. And its dimension is 50 comma 50 by 3 that we have already designed. And now we are predicting the image. And here you can see that our model has predicted with 75% of accuracy that image have mask. With 24.70%, it says no, it does not have mask. Now we are using tf.math.argmax. It will just check which value, that means which index value is greater. So here you can see that we have 75% or 0.7 is greater than 0.2. So it will return 1, as the value at index 1 is greater than the value at index 0. So if we check is mask, it is 1. So this is the work of argmax, that means the maximum value of the argument. And the argument we are passing this array, and we are checking whether there is a mask or not. And if there is mask, we will just put the text yes. So here you can see that we got the output of mask yes. Now let's explore this concept in live detection. Again, for live face mask detection, you need to import some module that are TensorFlow, Keras, and CV2, Matplotlib, Time, and NumPy. We will make use of all these modules later on. So let's begin with loading our model, that is cnn.h5 using keras.models.loadModel into the model variable. And if you check the model variable, it's a sequential model. So here we are defining a function that will check whether the image has mask or not. So this check mask will take a parameter of a master image. And here we have a dictionary with 0 means no, 1 means yes, that means mask no or mask yes. Then we are converting our image to grayscale image and saving that to original image variable. And we are declaring a flag is mask as 0. And again we are doing the same pre-processing that we have done for the static face mask detection. That means reshaping the image to 50 by 50, converting them so that they can be predicted by the model. And then we are using argmax to check whether the model have predicted the image as having mask or not. And then if there is mask, we will put the text based on whether the image having mask or not by using this statement. So here you can see that we are putting a text as mask and then the mask status, the key value. So the argmax can give us either 0 or 1. If it gives us 1, then it will represent yes, and if it gives us 0, then it will represent no. So that's how this check mask function is working. We are just taking the image, pre-processing the image as we have did in static face mask detection, and then we are putting the text on the image. So these are the three basic steps that we are following in this check mask function. And here we are taking a live feed from our camera. That's why we have said cv2.videocapture0, that means your default camera. And also you can use a pre-recorded video for checking whether that video having a person with mask or not. And then we are checking whether our video is running or not. So we are say cap.isOpen, and if there is an error, it will print there is an error in loading your video file. And in this block of code, we are just reading video from your camera and showing that in a frame called title. And if escape is pressed, then break the loop and destroy all window. So that's all is working in this block of code. And here you will see a mysterious line of code that says time.sleep 1 by fps of the video. It is important when you are reading a video from a file, because OpenCV go through that file very fast. So for humans to understand, we need to slow down the video. That's why I have added this statement. By the way, here we are using the live feed. That's why you can comment this statement. Now again, run this cell and you will see that we got the live feed from our camera. And now I will put the mask on. And now you can see here that we got mask, yes. And if I remove this, you will see that we got mask, no. So that's all for this lecture. And don't forget to grab your source code from the description. Thank you. See you in the next lecture.